Hey everyone, this week we're going to create the eye-popping 3D pop-out look, or otherwise known as the out-of-bounds look. We're going to cover this in four easy steps, so let's get started. The first step we're going to do is to cut out and mask the screen. Alright, so we're going to start with the polygon lasso tool. Now if you hold down the Alt or the Option key and use the scroll wheel, you can zoom in and get nice and accurate in here. So we tap on the first corner, hit the space bar and drag to get to the next corner. Let's do this to the third corner. And as you can see, it's like getting a little gum stuck on the bottom of your shoe and you just click and drag. Super easy. Let's go to this one. Don't worry about the hand. Let's just finish this. Now to close this, see where that turns into that little circle? Click, and that gives us a selection. All right, we want to remove the hand from here. So we're just going to grab the quick selection tool, and we want to take away. So hold down the Alt key. That would be Option on Mac. You see a little minus in that circle there, and we can just paint over the area we want to exclude, and it'll just snap to a selection. Great. Control zero will zoom us back out. And what we want to do is create a mask. So if I create a mask right now, it will retain the screen and it will hide everything else. We want to create the opposite of that. We want to hide the selected area. So hold down the Alt key or the Option key and then click on the mask. And that's step one. Step two, we want to cut out our subject. So this, we're gonna use this picture of the dog. Now, if you don't have this picture in here, you could just go to the library and drag your picture in from the library, or just choose File, Open, and then just drag it from the middle into the tab of the image that you wanna combine. So we have two images on two layers. All right, so I'm gonna choose the layer we wanna work on. And then we're going to go under the magic tools. I call them the magic tools. That's the object magic wand or quick selection tool. Go under select subject. But before you do that, go to the cloud option. If you don't have the cloud, it'll still work. The cloud just produces better results. And then click select subject. And we'll get a nice rough selection. Now we want to refine the edges of the fur, so we're going to choose Select and Mask. So in the Select and Mask workspace, we're going to be using the Refine tool. So this Refine Edge brush is going to be turned on by default. And if we use the left bracket key, we can make it smaller, right bracket key will make it larger. We just want to run this around the edge of the fur, keeping most of the brush on the outside. That's the secret to get a good selection with these. Go on the other side. All right, so this will just pick up some of the drips in there. The next thing we want to do is we want to go to the bottom of the panel. We want to choose decontaminate colors. That will get rid of any color fringes. And then we want to output to a new layer with a layer mask. Click OK. Step three, now we're gonna range and position this. So notice when we cut this out, we got a new layer with a mask. So that means that the other layer is still there and that's what we want. So let's turn them both on. So all layers are visible. Now I wanna drag this underneath the background. So we're gonna drag it down and you can see it's already starting to take effect. In fact, it's looking pretty good already. If you want to reposition this, hold down the Control key, that would be the Command key on Mac, and then click the name of the top layer. So notice the top and the bottom layer are there, and we're sandwiching our screen in between these two layers. Now we can move these two together. Make sure we choose the Move tool, and now we can reposition these. And notice as we reposition, see how that background is hidden and the foreground protrudes or comes forward. So you can do whatever you want. You can position it. If you want to scale or rotate, hit Control T, that would be Command T on the Mac, and this will enable you to rotate, and this will also enable you to resize this. I kind of like where it is. So the next step is adding a shadow. If you're getting any value out of this, hit the subscribe button and you won't miss any of my tutorials. All right, step four, adding the shadow. So we're going to choose the top layer, make sure the other layers are not selected, and then we're going to go under the effects, and then we're going to choose a drop shadow. The layer style box will appear. Now you can position the shadow if you want by simply dragging on the image. Not every image will require a shadow, but sometimes it's going to work well. But what we want to do is we want to hide the shadow from the area behind the screen and maybe feather it going in here. To make the shadow softer, change the size. To make it harder, drop it down. I might just take the opacity down a little bit as well. Click OK to apply. All right, how do we trim the shadow without affecting the rest of the image? The first thing we need to do is put it on its own layer. And we can do that by choosing effects and right clicking, and then we're going to choose create layer. Click OK. And now we just have a regular shadow on its own layer, which gives us all the flexibility that we need. Okay, so let's choose our shadow layer. And now we're going to create a layer mask. Click on the layer mask. And now we need to make a selection around our tablet. But we've already made this selection, so why don't we reuse our old selection? So if we roll over the mask, now hold down the control key on Mac, that would be Command on Windows, and you'll see a little square. Click, and it will load that into a selection. Now choose the mask from the shadow layer, and we want to paint with black. Choose a brush, hit the D key to reset foreground background colors, and then hit the X key, and that will get black as our foreground. Make sure opacity and flow are turned all the way up, and then just paint away the shadow from the area that we don't want it. Let's turn off the selection, Control D. And one of the things you might want to do is just maybe feather this shadow a little bit going into the picture. So hit the right bracket key, make this brush really big. And then you could just paint a little bit on the edge, and you can see it'll just kind of feather it away. And here's our final result. So why don't you give this a try and share your result with us on our Facebook group. I'll add a link into the show notes. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and found it easy enough to follow along. Let me know in the comments underneath if you learned anything new and also what you'd like to see me cover in a future tutorial. And by the way, if you guys are new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. And do me a favor, hit the like button, it helps with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.